Being sick and tired of waiting when my PlayStation 3 firmware will finally get PlayStation 2 backward compatibility, I decided to try out the PS2 emulator for my computer. Thankfully, out of all the vast PS2 library, I really wanna play free titles only. The emulator itself caused zero issues, since you can get a ready-to-play package with all the necessary BIOSes and all that. However, out of the three games, only one runs somewhat smoothly, but I guess that's hardware limitation of my laptop. Need more processing power. But there were problems while connecting PS3 DualShock 3 gamepad to my PC. For some unknown reason, Sony, while using standard USB connection, did not make the gamepad a standard wired game controller. Same with the wireless connection. While using standard Bluetooth technology, the gamepad is not visible for standard Bluetooth device. I really think manufacturers should be prosecuted for using proprietary interfaces and connections. Sony may have done this in fear of losing the aftermarket for its own device, which is somewhat proved by removing third-party USB game controller support from later versions of PS3 firmware. However, this doesn't really prevent China from making shitload of compatible gamepads for the PS3. Microsoft went to even higher lengths in their proprietness. Beside the standard USB connection soldered in a non-standard way, they also use a proprietary protocol for wireless connection, which is claimed to have less latency. The funny thing is, when you plug this controller to the console for charging, it indeed uses USB for power, but the data connection remains wireless. A wireless Xbox 360 gamepad cannot be detected as a USB device at all. However, a wired Xbox 360 controller gets detected as a Windows game controller no problem, and you can use this controller in PC games. This is not true about Sony. You have to pull tricks here. The trick is called Motion Enjoy. This is a utility from China, which, in awkward way, but does implement PC support for DualShock 3 controller. It's worth mentioning that even though the utility is free, it was not created to bring you the joy of PC gaming. The very essence of its existence is to show Google AdSense ads to as much viewers as possible, to financially support the developer. So the program doesn't even work without active internet connection, keep that in mind. Apart from the PCSX2 emulator and the Motion Enjoy, you will also require a modified pad plugin for the emulator. Downloaded, the archive will have two files. One is a DLL, which you must unpack into plugins folder inside PCSX2 folder. And the other is keybindings configuration file, which you should place into Inis folder. Now run Motion Enjoy and connect PS3 6xx or DualShock 3 controller to the PC using a USB cable. The gamepad will start to blink all four lights simultaneously. After you plug in the controller, driver manager section of Motion Enjoy should get a new entry. Tick it and click Load Driver. Device manager should have a new device, Motion Enjoy Virtual X input, and the gamepad will now blink the four lights one by one, indicating that it is charging. On the Profiles tab, the gamepad will appear as a connected device, however the emulator will still list it as detached. You probably thought of pressing PS button to wake the controller up, but it does nothing. So how do you force PCSX2 to attach your gamepad? It's simple. In Motion Enjoy, choose PlayStation 2 for PCSX2 profile. Now click Vibration Testing. As soon as you click this button, the emulator will show DualShock 3 as an attached device. The only thing left to do is to click Load Bindings and use the Lilia configuration file that was inside the modified pad plugin package. You are ready to play. Vibration, analog sticks, it all works.